The most exciting thing about being part of this movie is, oh gosh, there's so many exciting things. It's working with Tim Burton's amazing. Working with the amount of people that we're working with is really exciting. It's, you know, there's always a new face on set, and everybody, all the cast and all the crew are so lovely, and they're loving what they're doing, which is just such a pleasure to be around. But the most amazing thing is my character. I love my character so much. I think she's adorable, and I'm having such fun playing her. I play Olive, and she's a wonder to play. I love her so much. She's very adorable. She's sensitive. She's very loving. She's caring. Which is so ironic because she's almost got the most destructive peculiarity. She sets fire to things, and everything she touches sets alight, which is a huge power, but she never abuses it. She only really uses it to help. Some are invisible, some are weird enough to bring dead things back alive. Some have bees coming out their mouths, some are super strong, some have teeth at the back of their head, and they live they live in loops, but they live all across the globe, but in secret kind of coves and snippets of time, and they keep replaying it over and over again. The beautiful Ava Green plays Miss Peregrine, and I love her, the way she moves around set or around a scene. It's very poised, it's very in control, which really reflects visually the kind of personality that Miss Peregrine has. She's very organized, very efficient, very in control, very powerful, and to visually display that is creates such a presence. And I love the way she speaks as well. I think that's also reflects the efficient nature of Miss Peregrine. It's very clipped and to the point and articulated, and yes, I think she's doing a marvelous job. The innocence that he brings to the character is really welcoming and inviting, and it makes any viewer or any audience of any age really relate to Jake and relate to how this is a new world for him, and it's a really weird, peculiar world, but at the same time it's very welcoming and it's inviting, and it's nice to see how he's everybody's already accepted him, but it's nice to see how he accepts everyone and accepts this world and then starts to really integrate into it. Tim Burton is directing this film, and he is such an amazing person to work with. He's an actor's director. He really makes sure that you as an actor understands your role and understands what your character's going to be doing in the scene and what she's going to be doing or what they're going to be doing. And that's really nice to have, because it can kind of get very hectic with all the things that have to be done and organized, like the lighting and the sound and continuity and costume and hair and makeup. There's so many elements of what you see on screen that sometimes you can get a bit lost, and it can be very overwhelming, and to make sure you always have that communication with the director is really nice. And he's very creative and a very visual person, and it's really nice to work with because it's different, and he's amazing and he's very talented, and he knows exactly how to evoke a certain emotion from a scene as visually striking as possible. So it's really nice to work with, and it's just a pleasure to watch him work it out in his head and pace around a bit. It's really nice. I think Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children is such a different film. It's about so many different things, and it can appeal to so many different people. And so I think it's very easy to love because so many people can talk about it and so many people can relate to it. And there are so many different themes which are explored in it, like love, growth, death, thinking about them. Lots of different themes which I think will pick on a lot of different people's kind of past experiences or memories or emotions. And I think it's hard not to love all the characters because they're so peculiar and so just inviting in a very odd kind of way. I think what the film is really, really good at showing is that being peculiar and being slightly weird and being perhaps a bit different is fine. I think everybody's like that. I think everybody's got a bit of a weird thing. And I think it's great that the film encourages to accept it and to live with it. And it's not a problem for any of the peculiars. It's not seen as something which they is used as an exclusion power. It's used as an invitation, really, into a new group. And I think that's really nice. I think it encourages lots of, it will encourage lots of the watchers and the viewers to embrace their odd element and their peculiarity, and just kind of live their life as who they really are and not fitting to a form or fitting to somebody's perfect idea.
Did you know that Pumbaa in The Lion King was the first character to fart in a Disney movie? For this and more movie facts, click on more videos.